Karl Marx's Economic and Philosophical Manuscripts of 1844 were written when he was in his mid-20s and living in Paris. Their notes on human potentiality and entrapment are there based on an assumption that he later rejected, that there is a fixed human nature, a species being, as he put it. Whether his abandonment was coherent or justifiable is a question on which scholars disagree. Once he clarified and evaluated his ideas, he put the manuscripts away. They weren't published until 1932, 49 years after his death and 15 years after the Russian Revolution. Their enduring value lies in his theory of alienation. In everyday speech, we use the term alienation to mean a feeling of rejection or loneliness, but in Marx it refers to the fact of being excluded from things that ought to belong to you. It may have no subjective accompaniment at all. Capitalism is its prime cause, and it has four aspects. Let's imagine that you're a worker on a production line in a factory that makes some object, let's call it X, for sale. Firstly, you're alienated by the X itself. Under capitalism, it's always going to be more than the sum of your contribution to it. In relation to you, it's an alien object. Secondly, you're alienated from yourself because you don't see your work as part of your real life. You're essentially a creative being, but you've been reduced to pulling levers and pushing buttons. All you've been left with is your animal side, eating, drinking, having sex. And fatally, that's where you now feel at home. Thirdly, the species life has been taken away from everyone on that production line. Creativity is a social activity, but on the factory floor, you're all cogs in a machine. You're all alienated from your shared, creative human nature. Finally, and this is a related point, you're alienated from everyone else, from your fellow man. You can't function as part of the human community, not solely on the basis of a shared interest in eating, drinking, and having sex. Marx's solution to this is truly human production, in which I create worthwhile products for the actual community. In giving them to you, this is a world in which money, also a form of alienation, has been abolished. I see myself reflected in your appreciation, my genuinely productive labour, and in the creative process itself. Such a solution can't be achieved under capitalism, Marx thinks. It requires common ownership of the means of production. Communism, in other words. What's great about all this isn't so much the solution as the diagnosis of the problem. It still speaks, I think, to work in the 21st century.